Hi, kindergarten. How are you? I hope you're doing well. Let's practice a few more letters today. This is the letter S. S the snake slithers. S, s, s. Do you hear the sound S makes? S. Let's make that sound as you make, pretend your hand's the snake and it's slithering. S, s, s. S the snake slithers. S the snake says, as she slithers along the sunny seashore looking for a spot to sleep. She slithers from side to side in the sun. Suddenly, a sailor on the sea sees the snake and says, "You should wear sunscreen or you will sunburn for sure." She says to the sailor as she slowly slithers into the shade away from the scorching sun to sleep. S the snake snoozes in the shade. Can you make the sound of S the snake? S, s, s. Here's another one. This is T the tiger. He's going to tap his tooth like this. Can you t, t, tap your tooth? T, t, t. T the tiger taps. T the tiger taps and taps his troublesome tooth, t, 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 all the day long on a terrible Tuesday. He taps, t, 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 and taps, t, 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 and taps, t, t, t. Finally, his tooth tumbles out. Ta-da! He shouts, "I will not have to tolerate that troublesome tooth anymore." T, t, t. Very good. You have learned so many letters. Let's not do all of them right now, but we're going to review starting with K. K the kangaroo kicks. K, k, k. L the lizard licks. L, l, l. M the moose munches. Mm, mm, mm. N the newt is naughty. Mm, mm, mm. O the ostrich sings opera. Ah, ah, ah. P, the pelican pops. P, p, p. Q, the queen bee quilts. Qua, qua, qua. R, the rhino races. R, r, r. S, the snake slithers. S, s, s. And T, the tiger taps his tooth. T, t, t. Very good. You've done great. I think we only have 6 letters left. Great work. Well, now that we're done with our amazing animal alphabet for today, we're going to work on 2 little symbols. This one is called a period. And this one is called a question mark. Do you know when to use a period and when to use a question mark? I think you do. And if you don't yet, that's okay. We'll keep practicing. Okay, we use a period at the end of a statement. That's whenever you just say a sentence that just is. You're not extremely excited about it or anything, and it's not a question. You're not asking something. If you're not asking something, it's a statement, and you need a period. But what if you are asking something? If you're going to ask something, you're asking a question, and you need a question mark. What a good name for it. Question mark, because it's the mark you make at the end of a question. A question mark. A question mark looks like this. A period looks like this. All right, I have a few sentences for us to look at, and you're going to help me decide if they need a period or a question mark. Do you know Zach? Let's listen to that sentence again. Is it a statement that needs a period or a question that needs a question mark? Do you know Zach? It is a question. Do you know Zach? Zach is my friend. Let's try that again. Zach is my friend. Do you think that needs a period or a question mark? It needs a period. It's just a statement. Zach is my friend. The period goes right at the end of the sentence. He has red hair and blue eyes. Is that a question? No, it's not a question. So it must need a period. He has red hair and blue eyes. So there's our period. Let's try my last one here. Who is your friend? Who is your friend? It's a question. You need your question mark. At the end of a sentence, it needs an answer. That must mean it's a question. So you will use question mark. Sometimes we use periods. Sometimes we use question marks. Watch for periods and question marks as you read this week. I have one last thing to read for you. But before we read our little story that I have, because I've got a story for you, we are going to look at a different kind of writing. This kind of writing is called persuasive writing. Persuasive comes from the word persuade. And if you want to persuade someone, you're going to try to convince them to do something or to think something. And if you're going to try to convince them what to do, you need to give them some reasons for it. When we read persuasive writing, we always have what they're trying to convince you to do. And then we have some reasons. This time, I just wrote down two. Here we have something to do. It says, we should work hard. That's the opinion of what we should do. We should work hard. And I believe that. Why should we work hard? Here are the reasons. The reasons I have are, if you work hard, you will have a strong brain. Yes, that's a good reason. And if you work hard, you'll learn new things. That is another good reason. Let's try a different opinion. What if the opinion wasn't about working hard on your schoolwork, but it was about eating? We should have chicken salad. I like chicken salad. Chicken salad for dinner. We should have chicken salad for dinner. That's my opinion. What are some good reasons? Well, it is healthy. So I'm going to write the word healthy. Healthy. Ooh, it's also very yummy. So I'm going to write the word yummy. Chicken salad is healthy and yummy. Those are my reasons for the opinion that we should have chicken salad for dinner. What do you want for dinner? Do you think you can convince whoever makes dinner of what you want? Remember, go in with some good reasons. Maybe a good reason to have something is you have the ingredients at your house. Or maybe another good reason would be it's easy to make or it's fun to make together. I think it being healthy is a really good reason to eat something. And it being yummy, that's another good reason to eat something. So maybe those are your reasons. I'm going to read a little story for you. It's pretty short, but we're going to try to figure out what the author wants us to do. And then he's going to give us some reasons why. We'll try to find at least two. Let's see what we can find. This story is called Time to Move. Exercising is the best thing ever. Exercise helps people to be healthy and strong. Exercising will make you less likely to get sick. It will help you to sleep better at night and get more rest. Exercising also makes your bones and muscles stronger. With strong bones, you will be less likely to get hurt. With strong muscles, you will be able to move and do more. You can carry heavier things and move more quickly. Exercise helps your brain too. It gives you more energy to learn and play. If something is upsetting you, exercise can make you feel better. The best part of exercising, though, is it's fun. You make new friends by playing together. You can enjoy time with your family. At the same time, you are being healthy. Good friends and good health. What more could you ask for? So get out there and exercise today. What's the author trying to get us to do? What does he want me to do? And you, and me, and everyone. He wants us to exercise. So I'm going to write, we should exercise. He gave a lot of reasons to exercise. Do you remember any? If you don't, maybe you should rewind the video a bit and watch again. See if you can listen for the reasons. I'm going to list some now. He says, exercise helps you to be healthy and strong. Healthy and strong. Ooh, healthy, strong, those are good reasons. He says, exercise helps your brain. And he says, exercise is fun. Ooh, that's another good reason. I'm going to add that. Another reason circle over here. Fun. Now we know the author's opinion that we should exercise. And he gave us three really big reasons to exercise. There were even more reasons in here. He talked about not getting sick and your bones and muscles being stronger so you can carry heavier things and how it can help you feel better when you're feeling upset or sad. Awesome. Well, thank you for learning about persuasive writing with me and understanding that there are reasons for different opinions. I look forward to seeing you soon. Bye.